All right, Motorhead Rockers, it's time for us to reinstall the ECU, get everything back to where it was supposed to be and is supposed to be, and do some extra steps. So the first thing we're going to do, remove this Allen wrench bolt, pop off from there, take out these plungers. There's one here and there's one underneath, and that should give you enough access to get to the O2 sensor right there. Now, there's a couple of ways to do this O2 sensor. If you watched my previous videos, you can obviously remove this and then use a plug. And of course, then you're gonna have to unplug it from this rubber grommet right in there and then seal it up. Obviously, the easiest of the easy way is just follow this cord until you get to this rubber grommet, unplug it, and then just seal it up with some tape. That's the easiest way. This is something very hard to show, and I think this is why people don't show how to unplug this thing all the time. There's actually this slide, if you can see that, on the back of this, focus you fucking thing, this plug, you put a screwdriver up underneath here, underneath the main plug, and then you just pull up, and it'll slide right off. So, first thing I've done is go ahead and zip tie the grommet around the plugs, and then now I'm going to apply electrical tape to the top and bottom just to give it a seal. And there you have it, a beautiful O2 sensor cocoon that if you want it to look pretty, go ahead and spend the $200+ an hour at a shop to make it look pretty. But that is what I have done with this particular job. Isn't that beautiful? It's so beautiful. Now that we got the O2 sensor taken care of, now it's just a matter of putting this bastard in there, getting it all put back together, which I trust by this point in time, you know how to do that. And then starting this up. Disclaimer from Two Wheel Dynaworks. They say that you're probably going to get a check engine light because this was powered outside of the motorcycle. And that it's going to take approximately 2 cycles of the motorcycle turning on and off and riding around and bullshit. So let's see what happens. Let's get this thing put back together. All right, Motorheads, it's all put back together. The O2 sensor unplugged, the fairings put back into their gloriousness, the tank settled back in, 2 vent lines pushed in, fuel line reconnected, negative post put back on, nice lovely ass cushion right there, and a cowl. It is all together. So last thing to note though, when I start this thing, it may have a rough start and a check engine light, and it probably won't go away for, from what I understand, 2 riding cycles. So get out there, come back, turn it off, turn it back on, get out there, come back, turn it off, and then it should be fixed. If the check engine light doesn't go away, I am told that I need to get it manually taken off. However, it does not affect the rideability of the bike. So first things first, let's see if it'll turn on. By God, it turns on. All right, so yeah, we can see here that it most certainly is gonna have the check engine light on, but let's see, let's find out. And that's the rough start. You know, after I get back with a couple of rides and see what happens. This is the second startup. Sounds a lot better. So that's the second startup. I haven't ridden it yet. So second startup. I'm going to start it up a third time and then go ride it real quick. Just around the block a few times. While I let it cool down, which is always a good thing, by the way. So if your temps are a little high, of course, after shutting off the bike, don't turn it off. Let the fan cool it down. I think it shuts off at like 204 degrees to shut the bike off. But let me tell you, holy shit. It is such a different bike. This, okay. Kawasaki knows, okay. They knew what they were doing when they made this bike. This thing is fucking insane. But you have to do this process to do the bike. And like I said with my rant video on the Kawasaki Ninja ZX4RR, I said that it's a damn shame
that we have to spend extra money to get this to where it needs to be. But, if you can shuck out the, I would say, I spent like, what, $400 for the flash. We're going to include shipping in that. $300 for that slip-on. So that's $700. And then $100 for the DNA air filter. I mean, $800? $800 more. Because you already spent, what, fucking 10 grand on this bike, right? Shit, dude. $800 more and you get an entirely different bike. Of course, I'm going to do an update video. And of course, I'm going to do a ride video. Holy shit, though. And hopefully, with a couple of rides, that all goes away and we're good. If not, I'll take it to my local Kawasaki dealership and have them just manually wipe it. Shouldn't be a big deal. But oh my god, it backfires. It spits out hot fire, baby. It's fucking fast as shit. It handles. It feels so much different than stock. Whoa. Stay tuned, motorheads.